I signed up for half marathon in December for the popular Nikolauslauf in Tübingen. And to motivate myself to do the long, slow runs that I think are necessary for the preparation, I got myself a new toy, this Garmin Forerunner 945. Until now, I have been using a TomTom Sparx 3 as my GPS sports watch. Before that, I was using a Forerunner 305. The Forerunner 305 was my first GPS watch, so I was really excited to track the course I was running. The big advantage of this TomTom watch was that it was waterproof, so I could use it for open water swimming. The TomTom watch has an optical heart rate sensor, which was also a feature which attracted me at first. However, it turned out that this optical heart rate measurement is not very accurate for me, no matter how tight I wear this wristwatch watch. The Garmin Forerunner 945 is considerably more expensive than my TomTom Sparx 3 was. However, it's supposed to do everything the TomTom watch does much better. And in addition to that, it has many more features. The watch came in this pretty looking cubic box, which I will now open. Here it is. The protective cover on top. And that asks me to connect the Garmin Connect mobile app first to proceed, which I am doing now. Have a look what else they have in this package. It looks like the manual. And this looks like the cables. Connector cable. The setup was pretty much straightforward so far. I have connected it to my Wi-Fi. I've put in my weight. It calculated my BMI. The battery is already pretty much charged, so I'm surprised that I don't have to charge it. And I will put the watch on my wrist. And I think it has to be relatively tight to monitor my pulse. But then again, if it's too tight, it will be unpleasant. Well, now I have it on. I think it's okay. I have a small wrist, so I hope it will be able to monitor my pulse. The first thing I wanted to find out was whether the Garmin 945 measures my heart rate accurately with the optical sensor. So I went for a run with this Garmin 945 and with a Polar H10 chest strap. And these are the heart rates from the Garmin compared to the heart rate measurement of the chest strap. And this measurement looks pretty good. So during this run, the heart rate measurement on the wrist worked pretty well. Unfortunately, the optical heart rate measurement of the Garmin 945 does not always work well for me. During this interval run, it was pretty off during the first intervals. Only the last interval was measured accurately. So bottom line is, I cannot really rely on this optical heart rate measurement and I should get a chest strap. Now I want to see how well my new Garmin 945 watch works for open water swimming. Supposedly with the new software, the optical heart rate sensor is working also for swimming. I will also wear my Polar H10 sensor
so I can compare the heart rate sensor readings.
So obviously the heart rate data I got from the Garmin 945 optical heart rate sensor during swimming was not even close to my actual heart rate. Maybe the sensor picked up the heart rate of some fish or some birds that were swimming next to me.
I have the Garmin watch on one arm. I have the TomTom watch on the other arm, so I can compare the GPS tracks. And I will put my smartphone into the bag. Maybe this will also record the track. And hopefully this will be more accurate.
No, the track that was recorded by the iPhone in the back looks just as wiggly and inaccurate as the track that was recorded by the TomTom watch. And the distance looks just as inaccurate. However, the track that was recorded by the Garmin looks pretty smooth, and it looks like the course I was actually swimming. And also the distance the Garmin was recording looks pretty accurate.
To find out how accurate the Garmin 945 measures the distance during swimming, I want to put the Garmin watch into my swim cap, and I hope that way the Garmin watch will measure the distance correctly, and then I compare it with a measurement from the Garmin which I have on my wrist. It's pretty cold today, 11 degrees air temperature. I'm afraid the water will be not much warmer, and so I'm afraid I will not be able to swim very far.
My wetsuit kept me relatively warm, so I could swim some distance, and the result is pretty amazing. The Garmin on my wrist recorded almost the same track as the TomTom in my swimming cap, even though I was dipping the Garmin into the water during each stroke. So obviously the Garmin records the swimming distance during open water swimming pretty accurate, at least in this case in a lake on in very calm conditions. Since the optical heart rate sensor in the Garmin 945 seems to be not very reliable for me, I got this chest strap bundle from Garmin. It contains a chest strap for pool swimming, which is supposed to be very sticky, so it will not come off during flip turns in the pool. And it contains a chest strap for running, biking and open water swimming, which is supposed to be made out of a more breathable material, which is more comfortable to wear outdoors. And it also measures running dynamics. Of course, I do not yet know if I can make use of this running dynamics, if it's actually useful for me. This is obviously the chest strap for pool swimming. And this is the more breathable chest strap. I have been using this Garmin 945 for 3 weeks now, and it works for me as intended, in the sense that it motivates me to do my training. It shows a lot of interesting data, which is fun to look at and fun to follow. I do not know if the data is really that useful. Yesterday I did a long slow run and the watch told me the training was unproductive. However, I'm pretty sure if I want to do a half marathon, it's very important for me to do long slow runs because I need my muscles and bones and tendons adjusted. I'm sure this watch just tries to optimize my cardiovascular system. Yes, if the watch says that the training was unproductive, it does not necessarily mean that the training was really useless. Garmin gets their algorithm for calculating the training status from Firstbeat, and this is what they say about training status. Training status reveals how effective your training is for improving your cardiorespiratory fitness, that is your VO2 max. It is one of the most important parts of physical capability, but it is certainly not the only one. Being in good physical condition is also about strength, flexibility, speed and coordination. So if your training is unproductive from a cardiorespiratory point of view, it might still be beneficial, for example, for your strength or balance. Another thing is the running dynamics with this Garmin chest strap. It shows me the ground contact time and the step frequency and the oscillation. So I know that my ground contact time should be short and I should not oscillate very much, but I do not know if following this can really help me to get better, to improve this. A very useful feature for me is that I can listen to podcasts from the watch, so I do not have to take my phone with me during the run when I want to listen to podcasts. I transfer the files to the watch using the Garmin Connect software, and then I can listen to the podcast using my earbuds, and it works really well. I never had any dropouts. Another interesting feature and fascinating from a technical point of view is the map and navigation feature. However, from a practical point of view, I do not know if this is really useful because the map is really small. One needs to have really good eyes to see the map on this small watch. And then it involves a lot of button pressing to go through the menu to actually use the map feature. So from a point of view of a middle-aged amateur or age group athlete, this watch is definitely not a necessity, but it's fun to use. It's probably useful, and I don't think I will regret the purchase.